In this video, I'll be showing you how to connect your Commodore 64 or 128 to IRC using an EasyFlash 3 card. What you'll need: a Commodore 64 or 128, a modern computer, either Windows, Mac, or Linux, a USB to mini USB cable, and of course, better lighting and camera work than this. Before we begin, I'd like to mention that this isn't the only way you can connect your C64 to IRC, but the benefit of this solution is that it does not tie up the C64's limited processing power with the TCP stack. The computer you connect to it does all the heavy lifting, leaving the C64's 1 megahertz processor free to serve up all the obsolete communications goodness that is Internet Relay Chat, and to try to emulate 80 columns in software. I should also mention that the included C128 version supports its native 80 column mode and looks much better. So where do you get an EasyFlash cart? I got mine from Jim Brain at Retro Innovations. At $65, they let you do a lot more than just chat. There are 8 cart image banks and several kernel banks. I actually use mine to enable the JiffyDOS kernel for use with my 1581 3.5-inch floppy drive, which came with JiffyDOS on it. The EasyFlash 3 also lets you play special versions of games adapted just for use with it, and things like 2011's Prince of Persia, which can't be played without an EasyFlash or a device which emulates it. So now you've ordered your EasyFlash 3, and after pausing momentarily to stare at it while you're overcome with tears, you're ready to set everything up. Okay, now you may as well connect everything at this phase. Connect the USB into the cable into your computer, then the USB mini side into your EasyFlash 3. I have mine connected using an extension cable so that I can leave my laptop at its home on my desk using my TV as a screen. Now that both ends of the cable are inserted, plug the EasyFlash 3 into the C64 and turn it on. You should be greeted with the EasyFlash menu. Return to your modern computer and get ready for fun. The first thing we'll need to do is download the software. This package has been authored by Commodore Scene mainstay Tomcat, and you can get binaries for Windows, Mac, and Linux on its Commodore Scene database page. There should be a link in the description. There's also a good chance I forgot to put a link in the description, in which case there's probably a reminder in the description to put a link there that I did not read. Once you've downloaded the software, unzip the archive and open a terminal. In your terminal, or whatever equivalent Windows uses these days, navigate to the folder you just unzipped. List the contents of the directory. You'll see the binary we're about to run, and the PRG, that's the actual IRC client your computer will send to the Commodore. Now, before you can execute the EF3 IRC command, you'll need to flag it as an executable, at least on Mac and Linux. To do that, type sudo chmod plus x EF3 IRC. You'll be asked to enter your password, and if you're new to the terminal, know that you won't see anything as you're typing it. Once you hit enter, you're now ready to run it. All you have to do now is type ./EF3IRC. The program sends the PRG file to the C64, which then launches it and presents you with a selection of servers to connect to. From here, it's just standard IRC fare. Connect to the server, enter commands preceded by a slash, or whatever this thing is called in the UK. And it even has multiple Windows support. And if you happen to connect to Freenode, you can always check my PackBilly channel. If I'm lurking about, I'll be happy to have a chat.